Okay, so what I wanted to tell you is that yesterday, in the various slides we saw, we forgot to tell you that culture was really the beauty in economics. And this is what we discussed with Monica in our group. And I think that I can add a little anecdote to just show you how much culture can contribute and each and everybody's input in the excellence on this path is inversing some economic paradigms and contributes or brings a new, sheds a new light on this path. The anecdote goes as follows. It's the CEO of a major company who was invited to a concert in Paris, and the Annenchief Symphony of Schubert was being played. So the CEO couldn't attend in the last minute, but then he sent somebody else and said, well, tell me tomorrow morning why this work has remained unachieved. So the next morning he saw the report of his delegate who says, well, I realized that there were many people playing, performing the same thing. A number of violins, we could really delete half of them. And then at the in the background, the flute is really only coming in three or four times during the whole symphony, much too long, and I think it's their role is really minor. It really doesn't add anything to the piece. And I heard that several times the same melody is being played over and over, and I believe that if Schubert had, if he had reduced this by half, it would have been sufficient, and he could have achieved a symphony. So the report by the CEO is a little different. It's a different point of view regarding art, and this is perhaps sheds a new light on what we can contribute. I'm not going to keep the floor here, and I'm going to sit in front of my piano and then interpret, upon request, a gavotte by Rameau. This is a theme with some variations. We know that any musical expression stems from ourselves, first of all. We are the first reference system, and it's based on our own reference system that the variations are being played out. And I will then conclude with Schubert's Ave Maria.